today. Gorgeous one out there. Managed to make it up in the 70s, but here it is, bottled up towards the north. All this blue right here, that is cold air that continues to get its act together, and it's all headed our way as we go through, it looks like, Friday night into Saturday. And we're going to stay pretty chilly here across the area. Right now, we're warm, all areas in the 70s, and mostly clear skies. Nothing to talk about as far as radar is concerned. Temperatures, nice and comfortable. Maybe a light jacket needed if you're venturing out this evening, especially if you're prone to the cold. Looking at 67 in Jupiter, 71 in Boca, and already in the low 60s across the Treasure Coast. And as we let the temperatures fall in the overnight hours, again, once the sun sets, those temperatures will continue to slowly fall into the upper 50s. Tonight at 11, when Mike will update the forecast. And then as we head through the overnight hours, we start in the low 50s tomorrow and then back into the 70s. We love this stuff. Again, big area of dry air, just really taking out the rain chances, taking out all the cloud cover, taking away all the humidity. And there's much more where that came from out towards the west. Again, and it's going to be cold front upon cold front. As we look at the big picture, here's the jet stream. It's the river, again, that moves all our systems. And we look for a dip in the jet stream to allow that bitterly cold air to come in from the north. And that, as you can see, starts to happen Thursday and into Friday. In fact, we stay in this dip in the jet stream kind of feature as we go through Saturday into Sunday. So highs for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, as you'll see in just a second, not making it out of the 60s for highs here across South Florida. So the timing of the fronts, actually one weak front moving through for tonight, and then the bigger, strong punch cold air comes in through Friday evening into the overnight hours. You'll notice the winds pick up just a little bit, but the bigger noticeable thing is as you wake up on Saturday morning, it's just going to be downright cold as temperatures around Lake Okeechobee, right around freezing, and across eastern metro areas will be in the low 40s. But I think we're going to stay dry with these cold fronts, so that's pretty good news. No rain to kind of interact with the cold here across the area. So recapping your forecast for tonight, mostly clear skies, temperatures in the lower 50s. And then tomorrow, absolutely gorgeous day, mostly sunny skies. Temperatures will be cooler tomorrow than what we saw today, just 1 degree cooler. We'll call for low to mid 70s out there. Boating forecast, it's not looking good, unfortunately. It looks like until maybe Friday into Saturday, as a small craft advisory has been posted. Seas up to 9 feet, could get up to 11 feet, mainly across the Gulf Stream. And looking at a moderate chop on the intracoastal waterways. Sunrise tomorrow morning at 6:59 and sunset this evening at 6:09. And as we take a look at South Florida's most accurate forecast, you can see temperatures the next couple of days, low to mid 70s, but watch as the cold air moves in for Friday. Your high temperatures only in the mid 60s. We'll do that again on Saturday and again on Sunday as temperatures, watch that, low 40s to start on your Valentine's Day. And we stay pretty cool as we round out the 7-day forecast.